Hi everybody, Reinhard Biller here. The by far most watched video on my YouTube channel is the video about my camera base settings I use on the D5300, and I promised to make a similar video for the D500, and so this is what I'm doing today. The D500 has a lot more features than the D5300. And to make the video as short as possible, I just go through the settings I changed compared to the factory settings. So I have already resetted all the settings, and now I go through the settings that need to be changed for my needs. And yeah, I have also changed the language to English, because normally I use German, of course. So here we are, we're going into the menu. Then we start at the beginning at the playback menu. The first thing I change here is the playback display options. Here I set none to see just the image itself. Then the highlights. If you wish, you can also choose RGB histogram. But for me, the overview is fine with just the black and white histogram. And this is how the display looks like. So this is the standard view. With none, it is just a picture, so usually I use this, and if you press up once, you see the overview with the histogram and all the important values, and if you press up once again, you see the highlights, but in these pictures you don't see the highlights because it's not blown out. But for example, if I go to the next picture, here you can see the highlights, so the areas that are blown out are blinking, so this is why they are also called blinkies. And yes, so normally when I take pictures, I use this display, and to check the highlights I press up or down 2 times and then I see the highlights, or if I click up once I have the histogram with all the values, so really handy. Okay. And the second thing I change in the playback menu is the rotate tall. I set this to off, because otherwise a vertical image will just use the very small area of the display, and I rather prefer to rotate the camera to see the whole image. So then we are already at the photo shooting menu. Here I change the file naming, for example, to ND5. This is very good when you have multiple cameras, so you see directly in the file naming which camera this picture or this video was shot, so this is really handy. The primary slot is an SD slot for me, because I don't have any XQD card, so I just have the SD card, so I set this to SD card. The next thing I change is the image quality. I always shoot RAW to have the best quality possible. And image size, here you can select RAW large, but normally this is standard, so this is okay. The RAW recording, you can set here the compression, lossless or compressed, and I also leave this to standard, and also 14-bit is already the higher RAW file, so this is fine. For the ISO sensitivity settings, here you can set the auto ISO, for example, and what is important here is to set the highest, the maximum sensitivity. And I have set it to 6400, because more than this is really grainy, so normally I use this. The white balance for shooting photographs in RAW, it is not really necessary, but normally I use one of the presets or choose a temperature. Normally I use cloudy or sunny, depending on the weather. For the picture control, I use neutral, but as I shoot RAW, this is just affecting the playback, so to view the images on the camera. The next thing I change is the vignette control. I set this to off because I always post-processing my images and do this in Lightroom, for example. This is okay. The rest is fine. So we come to the next menu, which is the movie shooting menu. Here again, I set the file naming to ND5, for example. Okay. Destination is definitely the SD card. Movie quality is already high. Next point I change is the ISO sensitivity settings. Here again, I set the maximum sensitivity to 6400 and then go back, it is saved, yes. The white balance, you can use the same as photo settings, which is really nice. You could also use a different one, but I use the same as the photo settings. And here also in the picture control, you can set same as photo settings, or you can select a different one. For example, the flat profile, which gives you the most dynamic range and good potential for color grading if you like this, but usually I use neutral. The next thing I change here is the wind noise reduction. I set this to on. This maybe helps for vlogging outside. And the rest is fine. So we come to the next, to the custom setting menu. Here at autofocus, I change the AFS priority to release. I always want to release and don't want the camera to select if it is sharp or not. So the next thing I change in the autofocus menu is the AF activation. Standard is that when you half press the shutter release button, you focus, and I set this to off because I use the back button AF. If you have never heard of this, please look it up. It is really, really handy. Of course, you have to get used to it, but when you try it for a while, you will love it, so try it. Another great thing of this back button autofocus is that you can set the focus mode to AFC, to continuous. And for portraits, for example, you press it for a short time. And then you could also recompose, for example. And when you track a bird, for example, you keep it pressed. So it's really great. So the rest of this menu looks okay. Also the metering exposure settings are fine. The timer is fine. And you will see later that I also add this to my menu. Here you can set the continuous low shooting speed, how many frames per second you want to shoot. I leave it at 5, which is in the middle, it's fine. And usually I use single or high, continuous high. The next setting I change is the ISO display to see the ISO number in the viewfinder, which is really handy, especially when you use auto ISO. And I also set the viewfinder grid to on, which is nice for a better composition. Sync speed is fine. This is fine. And here we come to the custom control assignment. Here is where the fun begins. So the first one is the preview button in the front. This is set to preview, but I noticed that I have never ever used this feature. Maybe because the D5300 doesn't have it. And I set this to, where is it? To playback, because when you shoot, you have the hand, normally the left hand under the lens. And I find it not so nice to remove the hand and click this button here. And by setting this, I can just with the right hand, I can switch to the playback. I can set it on and off, which is really nice. So back to the controls. So the second one, the lower button in the front, I set to viewfinder virtual horizon, which is really nice. I like this a lot. because when you're shooting handheld, you can switch this on, you see it in the viewfinder, and this is really nice when shooting handheld, so the horizon is already straight and you don't lose a lot of the picture when you rotate it in post. The next button is the FN2 button here at the left corner. I set this to the top item in my menu. The AF on button is already assigned as AF on, so this is fine. And the rest is okay. So going to the next menu. Now we come to the multi-selector center button. I set this to shooting menu reset, is fine. Playback menu is I want to zoom in, but not 50%, I want 1:1, so 100%. And also in live view, I set this to zoom in 100%, which is really nice when you want to check the focus. The rest of the controls I leave as they are. And in the custom control assignment for movie, I set the preview button to open aperture. The lower button is already assigned to close, this is okay. And I set the FN2 button as index marking. Yes, this is fine. Now we come to the system setup menu. Here you can set the language, for example. And I set the information display to manual and to light on dark, which means here you have now the dark screen. I rather prefer the dark one than the light one, and I think it also needs less batteries. Until now, I haven't used this AF fine tune so far, but maybe I'll try this. And here you can add a comment or copyright information. I normally don't do this. And I set the airplane mode to enable, to on, because I think this also saves battery and I don't need this Wi-Fi, whatever this camera has. And also the send to smart device should be turned off. Okay, and now we come to my menu. Here you can set up your favorites you use many times. So the first point I want to add is the exposure delay mode, which is under the custom settings menu, under shooting, and D5 exposure delay mode. Okay. Okay. Next item I want to add is the frame rates in video. Frame size, frame rate, this one. Move it down. Okay. Third item I want to add is the ISO sensitivity settings. Move it down. Okay. Next item I want to add is the interval timer. Under the photo shooting menu, I think it's the last point, this one, move it down, and the next point is microphone sensitivity, okay, move it down, the next point is then monitor brightness. Okay, move it down. And the last point is the self timer. Under the custom setting menu, timers, self timer C3. Okay, and move it down. So So we are finished with the My menu. For example, when you are shooting in whatever, for example, in M. Or whatever, and you want to quickly access this menu, just press menu and then you're already in this menu, and you can also rank the items, reorder them or delete them if they are not necessary. And because we have this exposure delay mode at the first place, we can also access this very quickly with this FN2 button. For example, if I press it, I can select the timer, so 2 seconds, and now if I press it, there is 2 second timer and then the picture is made. And also you can set it off again here. And I think all the other points are quite self-explanatory, so you can select full HD 24p. Here you can again set, if this is on, you can set the value for the maximum sensitivity. Maybe you want to go to 3200. Or you can quickly access the interval timer. Or when you are shooting in the middle of the night and the monitor is very bright, you can, you can lower this value here, which is very nice, otherwise it is much too bright. And yeah, as mentioned before, last point is self timer. You can set the delay, for example, 5 seconds, and also how many shots. And yeah, you're done. So that's it. I hope you can get something out of it. Let me know in the comment section below if you learned some new tricks. And if you are new to the channel, please consider subscribing. See you in the next video. Bye for now.